In the previous video, I showed you how to create a new shapefile from scratch. In this video, I will show you how to edit a shapefile and create features such as points, lines, and polygons. Regarding the instructions on the Humboldt State Geospatial online website, I'm currently on step 29. However, just for future reference, these numbers sometimes change, and someday they might go away altogether. In ArcMap, on the table of contents, right-click on your island layer. Select Edit Features and start editing. Once you do this, the editor toolbar will appear. If this is the first time opening the editor toolbar, it will appear floating above the map document. I like to keep my workspace tidy, so I'm going to dock the toolbar on top. This makes it easier to find later on. Now, in many cases, the Create Features window pane will appear on the right side of the screen. Mine didn't appear because I turned it off earlier. To get it back, just click on the Create Features button on the right side of the editor toolbar. In the Create Features window, click on the island layer. This will activate the construction tools on the bottom. There are a number of tools for constructing polygons. Since this is a creative exercise, I'm going to use the freehand tool. Now I'll make a few smaller islands using the ellipse tool. Each tool works a little differently, and it might take a few tries to get used to it. If you make a mistake, you can delete a shape or Ctrl-Z to go back a step. You can also move features around. Once you are done drawing your island, go to the editor toolbar and save your edits. Next, I'll add a few roads to my island. Just click on the roads layer in the Create Features window to activate the construction tools for making lines. The regular line tool is a little clunky for this, so I'm going to switch to the freehand. Remember, if you make a mistake, you can Ctrl-Z to step back. Next, I will add trees as point features to my island. Again, you want to click on the trees layer in the Create Features window to get the construction tools for making points. Your points might try to snap to the roads if they are too close. It helps to zoom in. Once you are done, go back to the editor toolbar and save your edits. Then select Stop Editing. Now that I have my trees, I want to make them all show up at different sizes. You can do this by going to the Layer Properties and the Symbology tab. From the drop-down under Advance, select Size. Then choose Random from 5 to 50. Click OK when you are ready, and then click OK again to apply the changes. The circles look a little crowded, so I'm going to change the symbols so they look more like trees. Go back to the Symbology tab and click the point symbol to edit. Type Trees in the Symbol Selector search bar. Now you have a few more options. I'll pick Coniferous Trees Scattered. That looks a little better. Okay, I am at step 43 on the instructions. I'm going to name the roads on my island. To do this, I'm going to add a name field to the attribute table. This step won't work if you are still editing the shapefile, so double check to make sure you have stopped editing. Right-click on the roads layer in the table of contents and open the attribute table. From the menu on the left, choose Add Field. Name the field and change the field type to text. Then click OK. To type in the names, I will need to start editing. Go back to the editor toolbar and start editing. If you get this dialog box, just select roads and click OK. Click on the gray square to the left of the record you want to edit. This will zoom the map to that feature. Then double-click into the name field and type in the name. Just repeat these steps for the rest of the roads. Once you are done, save your edits and stop editing. The island is complete. Now is a good time to save your map document. In the next video, I will show you how to create and export a 15-inch map.